Okay, everybody, welcome to Final Fantasy 13-2, part 10. Fighting Caius wasn't going well for a while. Recorded about 5 or 6 different episodes, wasn't happening. Finally, I think I'm about to beat him as soon as I record off screen, so I'll bring you back to hopefully the end of the fight. And yeah. I'm sorry for not showing you it, but as you can tell, I'm very sad about how long this took me. Sentinels, great help. That's all I was gonna say. Damn it. Okay, no friends are back. Double back.
Your time.
The Pulse Knight. Okay, come on. Stagger. Come on, we can do it. We're nearly done. Yeah, this was basically my whole thing. Keep the Sentinel out for as long as possible. And I can absorb all the damage while directly attack. You have no idea how annoying I am. I have had to do this fight over and over again so much. It makes me so sad that it takes me so long. But come on, we're here to turn. I'm so angry at Caius. This is why I hate Caius. If his fights weren't so damn hard, I wouldn't mind him as a character. But because they are, I hate him. I hate Caius. But finally, we're done.
You shall pay for your crimes in blood.
Sarah! Stop this, Caius. I am not going to fight you.
Times have changed. I'm not the Caius you once knew. To change history is a sin.
It's too late. The timeline has already changed.
But must we accept this, Yule?
If you change the future, you change the past. You can remold history as your heart desires.
Let's go now, before you are made to witness more.
Okay, grab the artifact so we never have to fight Caius again.
Koopa? An artifact, Koopa!
What does Caius want?
No.
Girl, Yule. She seemed to know all about the Oracle Drive.
Did she come to solve the paradox too?
No, I think she came to... Wait a sec, Something's not right.
What? What's wrong?
Sorry, it's nothing. Just nerves getting to me. I thought maybe I was forgetting something really important.
Okay, so now we're gonna head for the gate. I'm actually so relieved that fight is over. I don't even think any of the other Caius fights are as hard. It's just that one. The chocobo! Okay, I'm gonna go for the gate now, and then we'll get ready to head to our next world. Use an artifact of origins to activate the gate and step into the flow of time.
Yes.
She was the same. The same face, the same voice. But even so, she didn't know me at all.
You mean you?
Yes. Well, no questions?
No, it's just sad about you. He wonders why I don't ask him about her. What should I say?
Seems to me that if I ask, you'd have a hard time trying to answer. I know what it feels like, not being able to explain how you feel, so I won't ask.
Thanks, Sarah. We'll talk about it soon.
Sure. Lightning, Noel and I traveled to Erba. You wouldn't believe how much happened to us there. We found a prophecy that the Seeress of the Farseers had recorded. We saw a young girl called Yule, just like the Seeress. Then we met a man named Caius, the man you were fighting in my dream. I guess what worries me the most, though, is that Noel looks sad. Sadder than I've ever seen him. And there's something else, too. The strange thing that both Caius and Yule said about the past. If you change the future, you change the past. I'm afraid of what that might mean for us. When Noel and I solved the paradox, we changed the future. Does that mean the past of Hope and the others has also changed?
You obtain a whimsical headdress. Sounds fun. Thanks to Sarah and Noel, a new timeline has been created. When a parallel world is unlocked, the O in the year is replaced with an X. For example, 1XAF is 10 years after the fall of Cocoon, same as 10AF. But the people have different memories as they led different lives. You can still return to the original date location at any time by using the Historia Crux. I will never go back there. Oh my god, I just hate that Caius fight so much. It's not even that bad, it's just... I don't know. I always have bad memories of it, so... I probably just... always associate it with being a hard fight. Okay, so... now we go into Yasha's massive... 1XAF.
At the summit of Yashas stands the ruins of the Farseer city Padra. This was the capital of a flourishing civilization storied in the annals of Grand Pulse. Here, the young Hope Estine is leading the Academy in an effort to learn more about the mysterious Oracle Drive. However, this world is not like the world of 10AF that Noel and Sarah had visited previously. Things have changed.
Eclipse is over. Or it never existed in the first place. History here has changed.
If the paradox didn't happen, then maybe Hope never had any reason to come here.
There's still the Oracle Drive. Maybe that would have been enough of a draw for it. Only one way to find
yes,
out.
Yes, Sarah, you're so stupid at times.
The foul sea that caused the eclipse. What was it looking for up in the sky?
Future, maybe?
I need to change all my paradigms to not boss fight. I'll do that after this battle. Because like all of my paradigms have a sentinel to some extent except for one. But now I'm going to be a bit reforged because I had to grind a bit for that. So, it's not going to be as fun doing the random encounters because they're all going to be really easy. I'm sorry, people of YouTube who shall be watching this in the future, so sort of distance. Possibly as people from this story. So let's go and look for this Hope character that we've heard so much about. Possibly different. Possibly dead. Since the timeline is different.
Welcome home.
How did you...
Yule! Did you come through the gate too?
The one you met was a different Yule. A Yule from the future.
What?
So, you don't know me either.
I know about you. I've been watching you both.
You can see the future, can't you?
I can trace the timeline. I see the future and lead others along the correct path. I came here to confirm something I already know. You and I are the same.
What do you mean?
You too can show others the way.
Wait. I don't get it. How are we the same?
Sarah, think about it. Just try and think about it.
It looks like Yule lives in this time too.
Noel, are you okay?
Yeah, it was just so unexpected. Threw me for a loop.
I met another guard with the same name and same face as Yule from the future. What could it mean? Is Caius here? I really want to ask, does Yule have a twin, but is Caius here too?
I wonder if Caius is somewhere around too, like he was back in Erba.
If he does show up again, it's going to be trouble.
Next time, I don't think he'll be so quick to let us go.
Yeah. Fingers crossed there is no next time.
You know that's not true. And any time you see Yule, it's gonna be a different Yule. Stop getting your hopes up, Noel. Just saying. You need a bit of tough love, kid.
We journeyed through time. Solved the paradox. And met two girls who looked exactly the same. And now, at last, we found our way back to Hope's Oracle Drive. He'll be waiting for us. Or perhaps he won't. Maybe after all this time, Hope has forgotten us.
He didn't forget about you before, and he won't forget about you now, Sarah. The only reason he wouldn't be there is if he died, which I always did.
I was afraid of what would happen if no one was here.
I guess the ruins were interesting enough. They didn't need the paradox to draw them here.
Sir, what do you have to say?
I'm with the Academy. I've been here for a while, researching the gates for the most part. There haven't been any reports of major paradox effects. However, the director ordered me to come here and investigate the area.
Okay.
It's unusual that this place is so crowded.
The sun feels so amazing! Time for my feathers to soak up some of that good old vitamin D for extra fluff! Oh, Chocobo Galena! Sorry, didn't see you there.
Who were you just casually talking to about the vitamins you need? Oh well, I can't... it's fine. She's a wonderful character as it is.
Thank you for shopping here on this bright and sunny day! I think it's time to hit the beach, don't you?
I would love to go to the beach. But... unfortunately, I can't. I sort of have something to do. Plus, the closest beach to me is a couple hours away, and that's a bit unfortunate.
Oh no! Did I miss the excitement?
Although, with the beach, I don't like sand.
Come on, help!
I like going to the beach, but I didn't like the beach itself.
I feel like I've woken up in a dream.
I've started investigating the ruins nearby, but to be honest, I don't even know what I'm looking for.
What sort of scientist are you? Where's your natural curiosity?
The Paradox research team is here today.
Director. Are you waiting for?
I don't know. But I think they'll be here soon.
Dramatically, what? labyrinth and dramatically walk up behind him. And surprise.
In a world where the paradox was solved, the eclipse never darkened the sky in the first place. No one remembered that Noel and I had been here. But, even so, hope was there, waiting for us. Of course, his memories had changed. We had our 10-year reunion all over again, as if our last meeting had never happened. When we explained his memories had changed because the paradox had been dissolved, Hope believed us without question. And then...
I have something I want to show you. This is a recording of the future. We're unable to identify the location or circumstances. There is one thing we're sure about, however. And remember, we don't know what era this is. Lightning is alive in that place. In my memory, Lightning disappeared after the battle with Orphan. But she's living somewhere in the future.
So it's not just a dream, is it?
She's out there.
I'm going to find her.
Koopa Koopa?
And you will find her, Sarah. After all, you traveled through time and found me. Many years of research have finally borne fruit. It all began with the Oracle Drive. We excavated it from ruins many centuries old. Yet it recorded an image of Cocoon, supported on a pillar of crystal. It was an impossibility. An enigma. Impossible, but a reality nonetheless. This is when I learned what I must do.
Koopa.
If it was possible to journey through time and look into the future, then it must also be possible to travel backwards and change the past.
Right.
I wanted to change history, make things better. Not just bring Lightning back, but Vanille and Fang. And my mother.
So that's what your research was about.
Koopa?
Chasing the impossible, you might say. But you've made me realize something. It's clear to me now we are not the only ones who are intervening in history.
Oh?
The past has already been changed. Sarah. You are the only one who remembers a time when Lightning survived the fall of Cocoon.
Yeah.
Director!
Not necessarily rewritten. It could be the original prophecy restored as it once was. Perhaps a continuation of the first recording.
If this is showing us the future, then someday Cocoon will fall. Noel, you told me in your time Cocoon didn't exist like it does now.
Yeah, it came to ground long before I was born. After it happened, the whole world just fell apart pretty much.
But who made it fall? Could it have been Caius?
No. He couldn't do that.
When is Cocoon supposed to fall? How many years? Is it soon?
No. Not for a couple of centuries.
Oh, that's a long time from now. I mean, none of us will even be alive to see it.
But others will. Cocoon will fall into Grand Pulse. Imagine the catastrophe. Think how many lives will be destroyed.
Right. That's the future I lived in.
It doesn't have to happen. No, we can change the future. We can stop Cocoon from falling and make your world a better place.
Yeah, but how? You think you can go to the time when it falls and hold it up yourselves? Do you even have a gate to take you there?
Well, we...
It might not be necessary to travel to the specific time and place.
How so?
The future depends on what we do now, right? Yes, there is a chance Cocoon will fall, but we can start working now to prevent it from happening.
Right.
But what if you can't, Hope?
We can at least work to mitigate the damage. If we begin our research now, we have time. Then, should Cocoon indeed fall, we can help protect the planet and save the victims.
Okay, let's do it. We could try to solve things at the other end, in the future. While you start preparing in the here and now.
Yes, let's change the future.
If you change the future...
If you change the future, you change the past.
Sarah?
It's nothing. Hope, thank you for the help.
Time will separate us, but we'll share a common goal.
Hope dreamed of changing the past. The weight of history drove him forward. But now, he's turning to face the future. A future even more frightening than the past. Sarah, do you believe too? Do you believe in your own past?
I still don't trust you, Alyssa. You child, you couldn't even leave that alone.
Lightning was fighting in Valhalla. That's where I met her. And that's when she told me to come and find Sarah.
I see. Valhalla, otherwise known as the Unseen World.
I think Lightning wants us to fix the timeline. Put it back how it was. Maybe that's why she gave me the power to travel through time and control monsters.
She was unable to do anything on her own, so she turned to the one person she trusted more than anyone. Yes, it is possible, although the idea raises even more questions.
How should you interpret the images shown by the Oracle Drive? You decide to ask Hope. I don't know. I really don't know. How do we see it? I don't know.
Listen, Hope. What are we supposed to do if we want to save the future?
The space-time is twisted and must be straightened. Find the largest paradox and resolve the contradictions. Tell me, Noel. Looking back from the future, what was the most dramatic event in history?
The fall of Cocoon, no question. Wait. Do you think someone created a paradox to make that happen?
Assuming such a thing is possible, then yes, maybe. Again, hypothetically speaking, I wonder if the man that Lightning was fighting is involved.
If he is, we're in big trouble.
I shall try to avert the tragedy. Then, just maybe, you will have homes you can return to.
Noel, what have you to say?
It seems unbelievable the crystal pillar could become so fragile.
It was weakened, little by little, over many centuries. The war was simply the straw that broke Cocoon's back. But what does Caius want?
Believe in your future. You can bring the people you love together again.
It seems unbelievable.
Okay. It was weakened.
Let's go exploring.
What does Caius...
said all... Oh, okay.
No. You know, I started this journey hoping to find my sister. But now, I want more. I want to save the future.
So do I, Sarah. So do I. Time to travel again.
Koopo! Find the gate and the key, Koopo!
Right now, we don't have a clue where the artifact might be. There are still some places we haven't checked out.
We should try asking some of the people around here. They might know something that will help.
Sir or madam, what do you have to say?
The director came by earlier to tell us you've been granted special access to the excavation site. The area where they found the Oracle Drive is up ahead. It's exciting to think there may be other amazing objects buried there too.
Okay. Well. That was a poster falling in my room, if you heard it. Okay, let's go to this big exclamation mark on the map. I have a feeling that there might be something here. Go, Mog.
Come on, Mog.
Mog, that's not an artifact. Sir?
Important relics have been detected nearby. Who knows? Any one of them might lead to an extraordinary discovery.
Do you mind showing me them? I don't seem to see anything important. Do you, Mom? Oh, there we go. I didn't see that. This is Mom. I got it. You obtained a mysterious artifact.
Alright then. Where's the gate that fits this key?
I don't sense anything strange within the ruins. But I did feel a disturbance from the direction of the mountains, Kupo.
Okay, so that will be us for this episode. Next episode, I will have calmed down a bit because I don't have to deal with Caius anymore. And we will look for the gate, go into another past, present, or future, distant or close. Same or different area. But until then, that will be us. So, see you in the next episode.